Over lunch for the four of us in the garden of the beautiful British residence in Washington, the not surprisingly wary and nervous British ambassador, Sir Peter Westmacott, was helpful. It must have been one of his more unusual delegations of MPs. We particularly wanted to meet the US Guantanamo envoy, and the ambassador arranged for this to take place. 20 minutes before the meeting, the envoy indicated he was not minded to attend, but the ambassador sprang into action and persuaded him to do so. We met at the State Department. The Guantanamo envoy arrived, stretched out his arms and yawned. Five officials from the State Department sat on his right and three from the Department of Defense on his left. "Gentlemen, what can I do for you?" The envoy languidly opened the proceedings. Over the course of the next hour, the four of us in our different ways expressed outrage at the way the US were treating their oldest allies. "If he is guilty of something, charge him," we said. "He has been locked up for 13 years without due process. He has never seen his son. The British Prime Minister has asked for his release. Our country has stood shoulder to shoulder with you in Afghanistan, shedding blood and spending treasure. Other prisoners were being released to third countries, including in Latin America, where the US were paying the host country to take them. How could the US treat the UK in this way?" The US response was deeply suboptimal. They alleged that Shaka had been a note-taker for Osama bin Laden. It was far more likely that he had been in the wrong place at the wrong time, when the Afghans were handing over any foreigner to the US for a financial bounty. There was some suggestion that the Brits would not constrain him, to which we replied that we operate under the rule of law, and that he would disappear back into the terrorist underworld, which we pointed out that we have intelligence services too. As we were wheeled out of the meeting, the senior State Department official ran after us and said, "Thank goodness you guys said what you did. It is the Department of Defense that is the problem."